stairs. Too many Indians and not enough sitting bulls. We're just some kids who like to sit and bullshit around while we reminisce about the shit we did in middle school. As if it's cool to be some silly, foolish clown who gives the rules. Ridicule cause we didn't follow simple instructions. Consider criminals by critics sitting in judgment. It was cruel how they treated us like we're minuscule or invisible. Do they pretend that we're nothing? How insensitive of them. It was really disgusting. No oxymoron, but I find it pretty repugnant. Luckily, we had tough skin ever since we were young men. Thanks to all them days that our parents whipped us for cussing or for being disruptive. In addition, every time we failed our spelling test, it spelled impending destruction. Surprised to find out that I didn't get a concussion for talking out the side of my mouth when I was just 10. They knocked so much sense into us, we'd eventually become rich. Not that we're men and women of substance, that's a freaking assumption. We're rich in the sense that the sum of wisdom that exists within us is in abundance. Used to live in dysfunction, just to pay Paul, we had to rob that family guy with the fat sits in the butt. And on one end, our patience was beginning to run thin, sick of having to punch it, cause it's getting redundant. On another end, if we don't, then we'll get done in. Can never get too comfortable in the system we're stuck in. Got unconditional love for our brothers, sisters, and cousins, and in some cases, wife, mistress, or husband. Cause deep down, we believe they're the only friends we could trust in, other than one figure who needs no big introduction. It's unjust to place any individual above them, cause of sin and corruption, that's the end of discussion.
Sometimes I frown, cause life ain't easy. Is there no such thing as happiness? Just begin.